Hey friend, Graham here from recordingrevolution.com. Today I want to help you get wider mixes using two plugins. There's a lot of ways to get wide mixes. I've done videos on how you set up your panning, how you set up your arranging. All of those things can help you get the illusion of width. Now let's take it another step further. If you feel like you need even more width in your mix, especially if you are using a lot of samples and virtual instruments, meaning you have a lot of stereo tracks that are all stereo. If you got like 20 stereo tracks, it is really hard to get width. It sounds weird, but if you have a bunch of stereo, it's like my friend Dave Pensado always says, it's more like big mono. Everything can't be stereo. So if you've done all the LCR panning tricks and you've done the arrangement tricks, pairing the left to the right against each other, check out all my videos on that, and you still need more width, there's two plugins you can use that'll really, really help you. I've got two of them in front of me. One is a saturation plugin, and the other is a stereo width plugin, which kind of sounds obvious, and they work really well together. Now, it doesn't matter which brand you use. Today, I'm using the Greg Wells Mixcentric plugin from Waves, and I'm using the stock stereo width plugin that comes with Pro Tools. So what I love and what we're going to do here is play some tricks on our ears. I'm going to press play, let you hear a part of the song where there's a lot happening, and then I'm going to turn on these two plugins so that you can hear what they're doing and how the mix gets more exciting and wider, and then I'm going to explain how this works. Take a listen first. Right? So if you're listening on headphones, especially if you're listening on headphones, but even if you're just listening on good monitors in your studio, you're going to hear the mix come to life and it get wider and more exciting. What's happening here? Well, two things are happening. One, if you got a mix working, and let's say this is, you know, this mix is pretty much done. Problem is there's so much. There's synths, guitars, percussion, drums, background vocals, all on the edges when they come in, and they're all getting mushed together a little bit. I've done some simple EQ, done some simple compression. They're at a decent level, but I want it a little extra. I want it to feel wider. And if you reference other mixes, professional mixes, you flip back and forth between your mix and the professional mix, and you notice that the width on the professional mix is wider and seem to be outside of your speakers, you might feel compelled to get your mix closer to that, which is the goal. That's the whole point of referencing. And so if you're feeling that, which is how I was feeling with this song, I think I was referencing an Imagine Dragons tune, and I'm thinking, I want to get more of that width that the reference track has. Well, then these two plugins work together. The first one, saturation is the key. Now, Mixcentric, to be fair, is really kind of three plugins in one. It's doing a little bit of compression and a little bit of EQ, but its big, big component is saturation. And this one is my favorite on the mix bus these days because it does so well with the edges. But any saturation or harmonic exciter plugin will work if you use it subtly, because what it does is it adds harmonics to your mix, especially to the edges. So it's adding a little bit of distortion, pleasing harmonic distortion on the edges. Take a listen when I turn this on. Everything gets just a little bit crispier in a nice musical way. So you could crank this plugin and it will just destroy your mix. So don't do that. But I'm adding a little bit of saturation, which goes on the edges. And then you're going to emphasize that with the stereo widening plugin to increase the edges, because that's all stereo widening is doing in a way, is it's increasing the apparent level of the edges while leaving the middle alone. And so I'll take the stereo width air plugin here in Pro Tools and take it up to 150% at the max. So you know, 0% width is normal, and then 200% width will be 200% wide, you know, twice as wide. And I feel like that's just weird sounding a lot of times. So I'll take it to 150, and that's going to increase the excitement on the edges that's already been enhanced by the harmonic exciting or the saturation. Take a listen. Right, so now those edges come out even more, and it's the combination of the two that I think work really, really well. Adding some harmonics and some saturation to your stereo mix bus, and then widening that stereo mix bus. So where are these plugins? That might be a question you're asking. They're on my mix bus or my master fader, and so I've got a few plugins going on here. This is an EQ. I've got Ozone on here as well. And Ozone can do stereo widening as well, so that's an option for you. That's just using another EQ. So it's these two middle plugins. I've got Mixcentric here, and then I've got the stereo widener on there. So everything is going through this. That's how it's affecting everything. So one final step, I'm going to take them both out in one fell swoop. So let me move this guy over here. I'll press play, and I'll take them both away, and you can hear how the width disappears. And there you go. You get a much wider sense of space and more excitement out of it just using those two plugins. So again, you can use any saturation plugin you like. It can be a harmonic exciting plugin. I'm a big fan of Greg Wells' Mixcentric from Waves. This is just a magical little plugin. This one does the trick really well on the edges. It works great with guitars on the edges, and it does a lot to the vocals too up the middle, but it really adds that sweetness on the sides, and then you emphasize that with some stereo widening after the fact. Again, don't go too wide, 150% at the max, sometimes 125 is what I like to do, and you might have to turn the volume down a little bit. You can see I've trimmed the level down by a dB because it's adding some gain, and I don't want it to make it louder, I just want to make it wider, and that combination works really, really well. Now, before you go, I want to give you a helpful resource to take your mixes to the next level. It is my 6 Steps to a Radio-Ready Song Guide. This is a beautifully put together step-by-step map. It's 6 steps to taking your song idea and turning it into a finalized, polished, radio-ready, Spotify-worthy, Apple Music streaming-worthy song that you're going to be proud of, that your friends and fans are going to be blown away by, and how to do it all with the gear that you have. What's amazing is that we could talk all day about plugins and these fun little tweaks, and that's only one part of the mixing process, and the mixing process is only one of those 6 steps. So to take your song from just being something that you put together a little bit on a computer and add some effects to and wonder why it doesn't sound professional, I want to peel back the curtain on the entire 6-step process that every major song you've ever heard has gone through. This is how songs are made. This is how records are made. It is a process. It's a proven step-by-step plan. And I outline it all for you and giving you a ton of tips and tricks and best practices in this guide. And it's absolutely free. Just go to radioreadyguide.com. Put the link below in the description box. It's here on the screen. Radioreadyguide.com. Download it. Implement it, use it as a reference for every time you make music. It's really, really going to help your song stand out. You're probably missing one or two of these steps. On average, what I've seen my students do is that they're doing only 3 of the 6 steps on average. So if you're doing 4 or 5, you're above average, but most people aren't doing all 6. So I want you to get the information and then have a proven map to follow so that your songs have the best chance of sounding as good as possible. Again, download it for free at RadioReadyGuide.com. As always, thanks for watching. Thanks for subscribing to the channel. Thanks for liking the videos. It means a ton. I'll see you on another video real soon.